Number one, who visits whom? In this case, as a question word, who and who are two question words that ask who. However, they both have different functions. Who is intended to ask who as the subject? Example, you, who invited you? A. Mr. Andy invited me. Meanwhile, who is intended to ask who as the object? Example, you, whom did you invite? A. I invite my friend and family. The question word who can also be used to ask someone as an object in this pattern. Who are you talking to? Or who do you live with? Number 2. Affect versus effect. At first glance, the two words above do look the same, because they only differ by one letter. However, they are too different from of the word. Affect is a verb of verb which means to affect. Example, but weather can affect my health. Will affect is a noun or noun which means influence. Example, in this modern era, we know that social media can bring big effect to our social life. But
mistake by mixing the form of one verb with another form of the verb. Common mistake, it is better to do some work well while young than spending all the time in play. Should be, it is better to do some work while young than to spend all the time in play. It is important to note that in a sentence like the one above, if the first verb is in the infinitive form to do, then the second verb in the sentence must also be in the infinitive form to spend, not spending. It's a common mistake to use the word home when you should use at home. Common mistake, in the afternoon I stay home. Should be, in the afternoon I stay at home. If what is mean is being in the house, then you must use the phrase at home. But when the word home, use a phrase using the word come, doesn't need to use a preposition.
What does it mean or what does it mean? The reason is because the sentence use a verb and the subject is it. Then we have to add plus because to be cannot meet verb one. Lisa don't know your name, or Lisa doesn't know your name. Because Lisa is third point of view, it use doesn't instead of does.
Number 1, loan or borrow. Example mistake. Can you borrow me that book? You can loan me my notes. The listener may be confused as loan means to give and borrow means to take. It's simple memorization that required to get the correct meaning. For example, borrow me that book means take me that book in the above example. Where do you want the listener to take the book? That is what you mean to say. Instead, you would like to use the book, so you want someone to give it to you. Correction, can you loan me that book? You can borrow my notes. Number 2, example mistake. Take a deep breath through your nose and hold it. The singular pronoun in the sentence should stand in for nouns, but here it's unclear which noun it's standing in for. The singular noun close to the word it is nose, so it seems that hold it means to hold your nose. Instead, we want someone to hold their breath, not their nose. When we use pronouns properly, we must easily understand which single noun the pronoun stands for. Make sure to be very clear. If it's unclear, don't use the pronoun or change the sentence. Correction: take a breath through your nose and hold your breath.